Hello and welcome back. My name is Adrian, and I'm going to talk to you about Meadow Foundation. So when you're building IoT hardware solutions with Meadow and C Sharp, there's a very good chance part of your project is going to involve bringing in peripherals. And by peripherals, I mean things like sensors that read the environment, maybe human interface devices to let a user interact directly with the hardware, or things like displays, LEDs, or speakers to give feedback to a nearby user. And traditionally in IoT, adding peripheral drivers was challenging. It meant finding a part, looking at the data sheet, understanding in-depth bit operations to communicate with each unique piece of hardware. And this is where Meadow Foundation comes in. And to explain Meadow Foundation, I want to go over to the Wilderness Labs website. So if we go to developer.wildernesslabs.co and go to the Meadow Foundation section, I want you to go take a look at the peripheral library list. And this gives you a sense of what's included in Meadow Foundation. Meadow Foundation is a massive collection of peripheral drivers written in C Sharp, specifically developed for IoT and obviously built for Meadow. And I don't want to scroll through pages of pages, but if you have a look, you can see there is a lot of peripherals covering a lot of topics, everything from displays to location to distance to all kinds of environmental and atmospheric sensors. And if you click on any of these links, it's going to go into a detail page. Let's find one that I like. I'm going to go to the analog temperature sensor. We'll jump in here. And we'll see we'll get additional details as any good documentation page would include. Give you some information about the peripheral, a code example of how to use it, and then some additional details that's relevant to each particular peripheral or part. Now, one of the really interesting things on these pages, if we go to the top, we'll see here, there's actually a table that shows some information about it. And notice, of course, we have two things. One, GitHub. I always want to point out this is open source. All the course is available. We'll take a look at that in just a minute. And also the NuGet package. And here we see the version. All of these drivers are published as NuGet packages, and so we consume them like we would any other NuGet package in our C-sharp applications. And this is a really powerful way to bring in support for additional hardware without needing to go into, you know, the details of the documentation for each part and understanding how they all communicate. And to really get a sense of this, I want to show you a project. The first thing, let me bring over my camera. And here we have a project lab board. Now, of course, we're using the Project Lab IoT Accelerator because it's a really great way to build, but you can, all of what I'm showing you here will work with, you know, custom-built hardware as well. So you can use a prototyping board and wire things up directly. And I want to bring in this additional 14-character display. It's actually using a controller called an HT16K33. Sounds a little complicated, right? Well, and if you're building from scratch, it could be, but with Meadow Foundation, it's actually pretty easy. So let me pull up Visual Studio, and I've got a project here for you. I'm just gonna tuck this away for the moment. Now, this is actually a copy of the Project Lab demo application available on GitHub, you can pull apart. And I wanted to use this because it shows some other sensors and it shows the display in action. And of course, here we've got all our output. So I want to bring in this HTK33. So I get that right. HT16K33, it's a mouthful. So the first thing I would do is I would head on over to our NuGet package manager and I'm search for it, HT16K33. And here we are, Meadow Foundation ICs, sensor integrated circuits, and it's an IO expander. It's actually meant to give additional input output capabilities often connected to a display, like it is in this case. We bring in the NuGet package, and of course we have this added to our project right here. And then, so now notice I'm not looking at data sheets. Let's jump over to our code. So in my Meadow app class, I'm just going to new up an instance of the HT16K33, of our character display, we'll call it. So notice here I make a field, and I'm going to use the search function just to zip on through to make life easy for you. And in our initialize method, I'll just scroll up and down really quickly here. So this is in the initialize lifecycle method of our Meadow app class, and then towards the bottom of that, I'm going to instantiate it. Now, a couple of fun things here. So the our character display, HT16K33, so it uses a communication protocol known as I2C. And this is a really standard communication protocol in hardware. If you're not familiar with it, that's okay. It's meant to allow a lot of devices to connect to the same bus. It's a two-wire bus We call it two wire, but there's almost always four because you need power and ground. And actually, if you look, we're wired up here. You can see we're connected to the quick connector on our board. And there are in fact four wires, ground, power, our clock signal, and our data. And then we plug that into the back of our board here. Now, over I2C, it is a shared bus. And because we're using Project Lab, in this case, we can actually access the I2C bus that is on Project Lab. That's part of, so Project Lab has other I2C peripherals, so we use that shared bus. And if we weren't using Project Lab, we had to create this bus. It's actually nice and easy. We actually just go device.create I2C bus. And then we could pass in, let's go var bus. And we could pass that instance into our constructor for our peripheral. But in this case, because we're using Project Lab, we're gonna leverage that same bus instance. And don't worry, this is all documented and there's lots of sample code to look at. So great, now we have a character display object, it's instantiated, and now we can start using it. And so as an example in the run method, we're gonna fire up and display a very simple method, message, wilderness lab devcamp WLDC, we got our four characters. We set a message and update display. And that's really all there is to it. And of course, we can do things like display valuable information. So if we want a larger display, or we want to eventually migrate our project to not being used this big 320 by 240 display, which does drain a lot of power, but want to use a different display, well, we could do something like this and wire up our 14 segment display here. And so in this example here, what we're doing is we're subscribing to the BME688 updated method. Now that is the sensor on the Project Lab board that's responsible for environmental conditions that gives the temperature, pressure, and humidity. And here you can see we're accessing the temperature data that's returned from the BME688. It's updated. We're grabbing the temperature value. In this case, we're using Celsius. We've seen this before. Again, we could do Kelvin or Fahrenheit. And then I'm just gonna C for clarity. We update the message and then we update the display. And again, we can see here, it's a little bit warm in the office today, another beautiful day, 34 degrees Celsius. And it's showing up and you're actually even seeing it, we can see it change. Let me bring this on here. And again, I think I was pointing this earlier. Let me show you here again. We've got the quick connector. There's four wires here going into our display. And let me turn this over for you here. See, I love these quick connectors. Nice and standard, easy, single cable to plug it in. And really just that easy to bring in what's actually under the hood is a fairly complex integrated circuit to control a 14 character display. We do it in just a couple of lines of code. And this is true for all the peripherals in Meadow Foundation. And just to give you a sense of some of the scale here, let me move my camera off screen. Here I've got the Meadow Foundation project. And this again is all open source, available on GitHub, and you can download it and look at it directly. And again, we can scroll through on the right-hand side here, we see the list of all the peripherals that are supported and some things to point out. So you can see they're all broken down into projects and each project will get published as a NuGet package. You can see the source code. So here we're looking at an ENS160. This is an environmental sensor. It's able to look at air quality data. But packaged in with every folder, we actually have a samples folder and every driver has an up-to-date sample that gives you crisp, clear reference points on how to use the driver. And these samples are meant to be very streamlined, typically only use the peripheral, the sensor that the sample is built for, so you don't have to worry about cross driver, cross parts. Nice and clean, nice and simple, and in this case, you can see how it's subscribing to get data back. There's another really powerful pattern in Meadow Foundation that we call the filterable observable pattern. Definitely look at documentation for more information, but we're pulling sensor data out. We often don't want just a single point of data, but we want data over time. We want to filter that data. We want to average out data over time to get rid of some jitter or some noise or anomaly in our data. Every sensor driver implements this filterable observable pattern and lets us do really powerful things like say, hey, I only want to get updated or notified when a certain condition is met, whether that's moving across a threshold or we're averaging a certain number of points. A really powerful pattern, and that's consistently implemented all across Meadow Foundation. I'll also point out a couple other quick things. So much to talk about. We'll go high level here today though. And if we go back and go back to the source driver here for our atmospheric, for our environmental sensor, a couple of fun things here, like this one in this case, we see it's implementing an eye concentration sensor interface. And we have a number of these interfaces for different sensor types. And when we have something that's measuring air quality concentration or temperature or humidity, they all implement the same interface, which means they all expose the same methods and properties. And that makes it really easy to switch between peripherals. So when you're moving on maybe from an IoT accelerator to a more custom production board, when you're ready to go to volume, you might choose to use a different part, something that has better availability, maybe something that meets your needs better, or maybe even lower cost. And with this abstraction model, it makes it really easy to switch between peripherals within Meadow Foundation, a really powerful pattern. And it means that when you have to update your code or make new versions of your hardware, it's actually minimal code changes on your side. Okay, tons to talk about. I only have a few minutes left here, so let's go with some of the really exciting things here. So code's great, temperature's great, but what else can you do with it? Well, turns out, actually quite a bit. Let me jump back over here. I wanna jump over to Hackster. And Hackster.io is a really great place to look up all kinds of project information. And you can see the Wilderness Labs team has done a fantastic job publishing all kinds of projects that you can build on Meadow with C# and .NET. And I love these. We've got animated GIFs for a lot of these. Some really fantastic, really great example projects. Everything from simple character displays to reading temperature data to even interacting with cloud services like Azure and IoT Hub. This is constantly updated, new project launching all the time, and this is a really great place to learn IoT. And of course, these are all using drivers that are published in Meadow Foundation. And again, really some of the big value prop of building on Meadow. Lots of fun, take a look at the projects, and you'll get to see more of this later on in DevCamp. So stick around, have fun, and thank you for joining me. Thanks, everyone.